Well, we've covered a lot of important definition material, and you may need to repeat this lecture a couple of times to make sure you have all of the numbers down, or you may have taken notes on that so you remember it. Once you start reading EKGs, it'll become easy to remember what the various intervals should be. Oh, the PR needs to be less than five little boxes and so forth. Let's do a case. Okay. Here's a 22-year-old male student who's the captain of the university boxing team, and he comes into you because he's having anterior, that is pain in the front of his chest. The discomfort occurs several times each day and lasts for 1 to 2 hours. On physical exam, he's very tender when you touch the sternum, and he did admit that during a number of boxing matches recently, he took a number of hits on the sternum. By the way, what are the important points here? Number one, chest pain. That's why he was referred. Number two, there's a history of some thoracic trauma. And here is the EKG. So, it's a normal EKG. It's the one I showed you before. So that's very reassuring, because what were we worried about? Well, we worried that maybe, you know, he'd gotten some injury to the blood vessels in the heart, and maybe had a heart attack during one of these episodes. So the patient's chest pain is musculoskeletal in origin. It's the result of the trauma that he suffered when he was boxing, and you can reassure the patient it'll get better with time. Treatment, you could give some non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents such as naproxen and reassurance, and no further testing is required.